prepping the floor for our glitter foam. We're going to go ahead and seal the cracks that are running through this really old floor. This was a cement slab that was poured in the 30s. And, you know, it's for a garage, they just didn't care. And there are just cracks everywhere. So we're filling them up. And the product I like to use is Quikrete vinyl. It's really easy to mix, it's easy to spread. A beginner can do it, you don't have to, you know, be an experienced person. You just want to make sure that your cracks are clean, all the loose stuff's out of it, and then you're basically just troweling it in and making sure that, you know, you smooth it off so it's a nice smooth finish at the end. Follow the manufacturer's instructions and you should be fine. So after that, we're going to give it a good 24 hours, if not longer, to cure. And then we're going to come in and do the acid etch step of the floor, which is going to give the cement, it's going to make it more receptive to the epoxy. Okay? So I'll just put the camera down. You can see me do a little trowel work. And then tomorrow, we'll show you a little acid etching. Okay?
So here's what looks like the Grand Canyon on film. And it is. It's pretty intense. It's a pretty big crack. But if you do a really good job with your vinyl patching material, you really, the important thing about Grand Canyons is you've got to make sure that the vinyl stuff goes all the way to the bottom. If it's just sitting on top, it'll sink. And the reason I picked this crack to show you is because it's the deepest one in here. I wanted to see, I could keep pushing and pushing and pushing until the crack won't accept anymore. When you know you've got that, you put more down. You don't trust it. It's not until you really go over it, over and over it, that you trust that you've filled it. And then you can just pull off the extra like that. Hey there, I'm here to share a little tip with you. When the stuff's put on, it looks a lot very sandy and kind of granulated. You might have some rough pieces and so forth. I've never known any guy or installer to do this trick, but what I do is I take an old sponge and I dip it in water, like so. And then kind of get rid of most of the water, but so that it's still down. And I run it over the joint. And when I do that, it takes all that sand, smooths it out. It also allows you to see if you filled it completely or not. You just work your way down the joint. And I find it to be a really helpful tool to be able to see if you've done a good job or not. So you might keep that in mind. And if you haven't done a good job, you can go back and fix the spots that are showing up. But the sponge and water trick is a terrific little trick for you.
Hey there, so today is acid etch day, and there is a video that comes with this product that is, you know, nothing special, but it takes you through the steps, and if you watch it a few times, you'll understand. So I'm not gonna take you through every step because they've done it for you. But what I will tell you is that if you have used the patch, you're gonna wanna go ahead and when it dries, take your foot or a brush that has some sort of tooth to it and work that joint and get all that extra sand off the floor, because otherwise it's going to get into your epoxy. So that's a tip that they won't cover in the video because they don't know that you're patching. Hey, so after you've cleaned up all the sand from the patch material, if you're working on an old floor, it is nearly impossible to clean it enough. This floor, I swept it 3 times, I vacuumed it 2x, and I can still see particles. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is do the acid etch, where I'm putting some water down, putting the acid down, giving it a good scrub, and then I'm going to be rinsing it 3 times, and I think by the time I've rinsed it 3 times, I'll probably have gotten everything up finally. And that'll have been like, what, 6 times? That'll have been like 6 times cleaning the floor. So you can never clean it too much. Just remember, if you see particles on the floor, those will eventually be part of your epoxy. So it's worth the time to do the best you can to get them all up. Okay? So again, the video does show you how to do the acid etch. I'm using a Hudson sprayer, pre-wetting the floor, putting the acid down, and then rinsing it with a hose several times until I've gotten it all up. Okay? So that's covered in the video, so I'm not going to elaborate. I'll see you, let's see, the next step that I'll check in with you on is laying the base coat of black. Okay, so we're here and we have completely dried the floor after the acid etch, and today is when we're putting down the base coat of black. And on top of that black, we will be putting glitter. What we're doing is following instructions, which is to mix part A on its own, and then add in part B and do a good thorough mix. And then we're going to go ahead and just pour it onto the floor and squeegee and roll it based on their instructions. So we're just going to let the camera roll and you can just watch us. Okay, so we went ahead and finished up the black with the glitter, and today is the clear coat day. We're going to be doing at least one coat in the morning, and I'll probably come back and do a coat at night, and that'll be done. We left the heater on last night so that it would stay fairly warm, and it actually did until we started opening the door. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and mix up our next batch and get busy. Hey, so we've gone ahead and the city lights layer's down, and we're going to go ahead and now do the fun part. We're adding colored ribbons to the floor. Now, you can certainly leave it the way it is, and that would be fine, but this is going to be an art studio, so there's actually no reason to do anything but other over-the-top type decoration. So we're going to be doing colored bands all over the floor. This floor is lightly cured. Not a hard cure. We've taken rubbing alcohol and cleaned the entire surface, and we're now ready to go ahead and lay the colored bands on top. And the colored bands are, again, epoxy and polyester metallic glitter, and some holographics as well, just because, you know, why not, right? So we're going to go ahead and just leave the camera running, and you can go ahead and watch us do the base. and application.